بعد أن يمضي مصر في شان مصر من دفور in the world. السلام عليكم everyone. Today my lecture is about the trachea and the lung. As you know, the trachea
بس العفو استاذ، الصوت انقطع.
لا دكتور، أنا قاعد أوفر أكو صاير سهم على البيوت، أريد أوفر شوية صوت.
هاي فوق فيو اوبشن، اختاري منها فيو اوبشن. اكو فوق تصير صف الخضار، يو ار فيوينج، شو اسمه، فيو اوبشن اختاري منها. هاي اللي شفتيها حسنا بابا،
فيو اوبشن دكتور، عندي ما جاي
فوق فيو اوبشن على مود البوينتر تطلعي غير.
بلى عمو، اريد ان اوخر هذا شوية سوا دكتور. بلى استاذ راح ابدي. As you know, the trachea is a tube-like structure consists of the 15 up to 20 C-shaped cartilage ring anterior lateral bridge by the annular ligament. The trachealis muscle encircles the trachea completely, but it is more prominent posterior due to the leakage of the cartilage. It begins at the level of the C6 and the vertebra and extends to the carina at the level of the sternal angle, level of the T5 vertebrae. During the aspiration, it's become at the level of the T4, and expiration become at the level of the T6. Its length is 13 up to 13 centimeter, and its width 1.5 up to 2 centimeter, and it is wider in men than in the women. According to the relation of the trachea,
شنو الإشكال بنتي؟ أكو إشكال؟ صوت يتقطع، كل شيء مفتهمنا.
Anteriorly, sternum, strap muscle, thyroid isthmus, ascending aorta, and brachiocephalic artery, right common carotid artery, superior vena cava, inferior thyroid vein, left brachiocephalic vein. Posteriorly, there is a esophagus, laterally, lateral wall of the thyroid gland, left common carotid artery, arch of the zygous vein, right and left recurrent laryngeal, and the vagus nerve. According to the arterial supply, the proximal part are supplied by the inferior thyroid artery and distal part supplied by parenchyal arteries. Venous drainage throughout the inferior thyroid venous plexus. Lymphatic drainage throughout the pretracheal and paratracheal lymph node. Here we see the right paratracheal strip. This is the radiopaque line here, which will be present because of the air inside the trachea medially and air in the line laterally. It should be less than 3 millimeters. Posterior tracheal strip formed by air in the trachea and air in the lung. It should be less than 3 millimeters, but if we see in this axial section, if we have the collapsed esophagus, it may reach to the 1 centimeter. Carina. It is the anterior posterior ridge at the junction of the main bronchi at the level of the T5 vertebra. The angle of the carina should be less than 65 degrees. If the angle becomes more than 65, we have to consider different causes, just like the subcarinal mass, lobar collapse, left atrial enlargement, cardiomegaly, and precardial effusion. Now we talk about the right main broadcast. Right main broadcast, another name for right main broadcast is mid-hip arterial. It means the right main broadcast above the right pulmonary artery. It is the shorter, wider manifold and more vertical. Relation of the right main broadcast anteriorly superior vena cava, right pulmonary artery, and posterior by the zygous vein, superior by the arch of the zygous vein. Right main bronchus divided to the upper loop bronchus, middle and lower loop bronchus. Upper loop bronchus divided, subdivided to further anterior, apical, and posterior segment. Then it's the bronchus intermedius and divided to the medial, to middle and in lower loop bronchus. The middle loop bronchus divided to the medial and division. The lower loop bronchus divided to the apical, anterior. تلعب دكتور صورة عليكم؟
ايه هسه طلعت بابا هسه طلعت
الصورة بالصوت واضح؟
صوت مو كلش واضح امينة بعيد مبين
أستاذ العفو صوت واضح عندكم؟
هسه تفضلي هسه كان هو ماكو ما كنت ساكتة هسه تفضلي
يا محمد
تسمعيني أسنان ألو تسمعوني
نعم أستاذ نسمع
صوتك واضح
من انقطع الصوت؟ Right main bronchus divided to the upper loop bronchus and the middle and lower loop bronchus. The upper loop bronchus divided to the anterior, apical, and posterior division. The middle divided to the medial and lateral division. Lower loop bronchus divided to the apical segment, anterior and posterior, medial and lateral. Left main bronchus, another name from left main bronchus is the hip arterial bronchus. It is the longer and narrower than the right side. Relation to the left main bronchus anteriorly by the pulmonary trunk, posterior esophagus and descending aorta, superior by the superior aortic, superior by the aortic arch and pulmonary artery. The left main bronchus divided to the upper and lower loop bronchi. The upper loop division are similar to the right. It's divided to the apical posterior, anterior, superior lingula, and inferior lingula. And the lower loop bronchi divided to the superior, posterior, anterior, and lateral division. There is no
صورة راحت الصورة راحت. أسنان.
لا صحيح. Bronchial artery. The blood supply, bronchial artery branches of the thoracic aorta, bronchial vein drain on the right to the zygous system and on the left to the hemizygous system. Chest X-ray, frontal and lateral chest X-ray. At the frontal chest X-ray, we see the trachea slightly deviated to the right, and in lateral chest X-ray, trachea should be the midway between the sternum and vertebral body. This is a 3D line and airway AP. You see the trachea and right main and left main bronchi, carina and medicinal area. This is the coronal section CT showing the trachea, right main and left main bronchi, apical segment of the bronchus on right upper loop and right lower loop bronchus. The line. The lungs are the functional unit of the respiration and are the key to survive. Each lung weighs approximately 1.1 kilogram and the right lung has a 3 loop and the left lung has a 2 loop. Now we talk about the fissure. We have the major and minor fissure. The major fissure present in both sides, right and left, and are similar in both lines. It's extend from the T4-T5 posterior to the diaphragm anterior inferiorly. The left major fissure is more vertical than the right side. Transverse or minor fissure, this separated the upper and middle lobe of the right lung and ran horizontal from the hilum to the anterior, posterior, anterior and the lateral surface of the right lung at the level of the fourth costal cartilage. Here we see the frontal and lateral view of the right lung. This is the right upper, anterior and lateral, right middle, anterior and lateral, and right lower, anterior and lateral view. This is the frontal and lateral view of the left line, left upper lobe, and frontal and lateral view of the left lower lobe. Accessory fissure. The zygous fissure, this is in fact a downward invagination of the zygous vein around the apical portion of the right upper lobe. It therefore has a four pleural layer, two vesical and two parietal. The zygous fissure, zygous lobe, and zygous vein. This is the chest X-ray and CT for the zygous fissure. Here we see the zygous fissure, zygous loop, and zygous vein. This is the axial view of the zygous fissure and zygous loop. This is the coronal section showing the zygous fissure and zygous loop. Superior accessory fissure and inferior accessory fissure. The superior accessory fissure separated the apical segment of the right lower lobe from the remaining segment, while the inferior accessory fissure separated medial basal from the remaining basal segment of the left right lower lobe. Left transverse fissure separated the limula from the rest of the left upper lobe. The pulmonary trine. It leaves the fibrous pericardium and bifurcate almost at once in the concavity of the aortic arch anterior to the left main bronchus. Right pulmonary artery, it is longer than the left and it passes across the midline below the carina and comes to lie anterior to the right main bronchus. Left pulmonary artery spiral over the spiral aspect of the left main bronchus to reach its posterior surface. It is attached to the concavity of the aortic arch by the ligamentum arteriosum. This is the frontal chest X-ray showing the trachea, and also we can see right and left pulmonary artery. Pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein don't follow the bronchial pattern but tend to run in intersegmental septum. Two veins pass to each hilum from the lung tissue above and below each oblique fissure. This enters the mediastinum slightly below and anterior to the pulmonary artery. This is the digital subtraction angiography of the pulmonary vein. It's drained to the left atrium. As we see, there is the right upper and lower pulmonary vein, and here right left upper and lower pulmonary vein. At the lateral chest X-ray, right pulmonary artery is seen end on, and it is oval in appearance, while the left pulmonary artery is a coma shape and is arched over the left main bronchus. They may each measure up to 3 centimeters in diameter. Lymphatic. According to the anatomical application, the lymphatic tissue may, just like the pulmonary node, bronchopulmonary, carinal lymph node, tracheobronchial, and right and left paratracheal lymph node in either side of the trachea. Lung root. The root of the lung are formed by structure that enter and emerge at the hilum. They are lie at the vertebral level T5 up to the T7. This is the right root, and you see the pulmonary vein anterior inferior, while the pulmonary artery become posterior to the pulmonary vein, and the bronchus is slightly above the right bronchus is slightly above the pulmonary artery. While in the left lung root, you see the pulmonary vein anterior inferior, pulmonary artery above the left bronchus. Chest radiological zoom, high description according to the radiopedia. We have four zoom technique. This zoom used for reporting if there is any pathology and not corresponding to the anatomical structure. We divided the chest to the four zone, apical, upper, mid, and lower zone. The apical zone is the area at the level of the clavicle. the upper zone area below the clavicle up to the cardiac civil side, and the middle zone area at the hilum, and the lower zone area of the base of the lung. When we describe the chest X-ray, remember this mnemonic: A means the airway, B means the bone if there is any abnormality in the ribcage, humerus, clavicle, vertebrae, C, cardiac, D, diaphragm, and E, equal fill, G, gastric bubble, H, hilum, and I, invasive line. But there is not any invasive line in this picture. Not forget the hidden area 2A and 2H, A, apical, A, area under the diaphragm, and 2H hilum, and the heart and retrocardiac cardiac area. CT level. There is different view, different level of the CT, but most important of it is this three level, trachea, carina, and the heart. At the tracheal level, we see the upper loop, left and right side. It is a tracheal level. We see the left, right upper and the left upper loop. Still, we are on tracheal level. We see the right and left upper loop. Carina, or area of the bifurcation of the trachea, you see the right side, the right upper loop, anterior, and the posterior, we see right lower loop. On the left, we see left upper loop anterior and the left lower loop posterior. At the level of the heart, on the right side, we see right middle loop anterior and the right lower loop posterior. And the on the left side, we see the still, we see left upper loop, but it's in the lingular, and on the posterior side, we see left lower loop. At the diaphragm level, we see only left lower and right lower loop. This is the coronal view showing the three loop on the right side and two loop left upper and lower, right upper, middle, and lower. This is a summary as we talked about previously. At the level of the trachea, we see right upper and left upper. At the level of the carina or tracheal bifurcation, we see the right upper and right lower loop. And at the level of the heart, we see the middle loop anterior and right inferior, right lower loop posterior. But sometimes we see the heart and great vessel, bifurcation of the great vessel. You can see right upper loop anterior, right middle loop in the middle, and right inferior loop posterior. And see the left upper loop anterior and left lower loop posterior. CT pulmonary angiography, this medical diagnostic test used for the image of the pulmonary artery, used for diagnostic the pulmonary embolism. As we see, this is the axial section showing the saddle pulmonary embolism. Bronchial angiography used for a diagnostic and therapeutic therapeutic of the hemoptysis. And isotopic ventilation perfusion scan is the scintigraphic examination of the lung that evaluates pulmonary vasculation perfusion, segmental bronchoalveolar 3 ventilation.
شكرا دكتورة حسناء. يلا عيني دكتورة حسناء، تسمعينا؟
بلي أستاذ، العفو، صار انقطاع.
يلا دكتورة دعاء، دكتورة دعاء.
نعم أستاذ.
يلا
وين السؤال
هذا
دكتور؟
شنو؟
شوف،
هذا السؤال
regarding the accessory fissure of the lung. A, the azygos fissure result from failure of normal migration of azygos vein from the chest wall through the lung. True.
This is true. Okay. أسماء معين.
نعم دكتور. Regarding accessory fissure of the lung, the inferior accessory fissure separate the medial basal segment from the rest of right lower lobe. True.
This is true. Okay. نرجع اليمن على دكتور ضرغام الموسوي.
نعم سير. The superior accessory fissure lies above the minor fissure. False أستاذ.
This is
صعب.
false.
هو ال superior accessory fissure separates the superior segment of lower lobe from the basal segment.
Excellent. إذن هذا فورس. بتقول محمد دي.
نعم أستاذ. Left minor fissure is seen in 10% of frontal radiograph. False. يعني دكتور هي الإجابة الصحيحة مات أنه hard to see in the frontal or the lateral radiograph.
صحيح. إذن هذا هم فورس. Last question حسناء.
نعم دكتور. The inferior pulmonary ligaments are poor reflections from the pericardium. False. From the root of the lung or the hilum till the diaphragm, medial end of the diaphragm. False.
Excellent. Then this is also false. And which بعد شيء؟ سعد محمد تفضل.
نعم سعد محمد. زينب سعيد. Number one.
نعم أستاذ. Axial chest CT. Number one, aortic arch.
Aortic arch. زهراء مؤيد. Number two.
Number two is seconds.
سالي كاظم. Number three.
This is the trachea. Number three, trachea.
Nada Jabir, number four.
Ustad, the right subscapularis muscle.
Right, left.
Right, Ustad.
هي غير تقولين بابا.
قلت دكتور.
Right subscapularis.
Right subscapularis muscle.
آه قلت يا. لا عاد ما سمعت انقطع.
يوسف ماير يقول لك what is the physiological finding or what is the normal variant in this CT؟
هذا الازاجس الازاجس لوب وفي الشرويات مالته. ازاجس لوب هذا.
نعم.
اللي جاي منها بالرأي.
حسن حيدر.
نعم استاذ. Play radiograph AP. Number one, this is the azygous fissure.
Azygous fissure. رؤى جبار. B.
B, aortic arch.
Aortic arch. آسر. C.
Medial border of left scapula.
دي وسن وسن محمود.
نعم استاذ. دي الرايت كارديوفرينيك انجل.
رايت كارديوفرينيك انجل. ولتر اي رفيف تركي.
لتر اي انتر لوبر ارتري.
خلصنا.